has blue bonnets in the summer. She's as hot as the Padre Island sun. Most of the time she's as warm and friendly, like the hills that surround Austin. She's as bright as the Dallas sky. She always holds her head up high. She loves the company of her family. She has faith in God's greater plan. She trusts I'm a good man, and that's why I'll always believe. She's like Texas, and she likes me. Her eyes are green like the trees in Nacogdoches.
Dear family and friends, on behalf of Chris and Amanda, I welcome all of you to this marriage celebration. We're all here today to encourage, celebrate, and support the covenant that Chris and Amanda now make. We also share in the joy that they are feeling as they pledge their love and commitment to each other. We rejoice in the ways life has led them to each other and got them to this time and place where they now stand. Who gives this woman in marriage? You may be seated. Start the real part of the ceremony, do a little history. Those of us who've had the pleasure of knowing these two for a while and their family knew that when they first got together, this was probably going to be a pretty good thing. After a while, we looked at it and went, you know what? It's a really good fit. I think this one's going to take. And then we waited for a while. And we waited for a while, and we knew one of these days Chris was going to actually ask her to marry him. And she did. He did, sorry. He finally did, and here we are today to celebrate that. We are grateful, as I said earlier, for everybody who's here. But we do need to thank for just a little bit about those who are not. And especially Chris's father, Alan. We know how proud he would be of the man that his son has become. We know how happy he would be that finally Amanda is going to be a part of this family officially. We know how much he would enjoy this celebration. And as big as his spirit was, and still is, we know that he's smiling down on this event and will smile down on this union forever. And we are grateful. For that. Let's get y'all married. Chris, the woman who stands by your side is going to be your wife. She will look to you for comfort, for support, for love, for understanding, for encouragement, and for protection. You must never take her for granted and always stand by her no matter what. Of you may encounter in life. Please repeat after me. Today, in the presence of God, family, and friends,
today, in the presence of God, family, and friends,
I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
Wherever you go, I will go.
Wherever you go, I will go.
Whatever you face, I will face.
Whatever you face, I will face.
For good times or bad times,
for good times or bad times.
In happiness or sadness,
happiness or sadness.
Come riches or poverty,
riches or poverty.
I take you as my wife.
I take you as my wife.
Amanda. The man who stands by your side is going to be your husband. He will look to you for comfort, for support, for love, for understanding, for encouragement, and for protection. You must never take him for granted, stand by him no matter what the two of you may encounter in your lives. Please repeat after me. Today, in the presence of God, family, and friends, I join my life with yours. Wherever you go, I will go. Whatever you face, I will face. For good times or bad times. Good times or bad times. In happiness or sadness, come riches or poverty, I take you as my husband. In the Bible, Paul wrote beautifully about the power of love in his first letter to the Corinthians in chapter 13. He said, if I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and knowledge, and if I have faith so I can remove mountains, but I have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have and deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. At this time, I'm going to ask the two of y'all to please join your hands while asking these questions. Chris, do you take Amanda to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live? Amanda, do you take Chris to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live? The wedding ring symbolizes unity, a circle unbroken, without beginning or end. And today, Amanda and Chris will exchange rings as confirmation of their vows to join their lives, to work at all times to create a life that is complete and unbroken, and to love each other without end. May I have the rings, please?
Good job.
May the Lord bless these rings, which you give to each other as a symbol of your love and fidelity. Chris, take this ring and place it on her finger. Repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I offer you my hand.
I offer you my hand.
And my heart.
And my heart.
And I know.
And I know.
They will be safe with you.
They will be safe with me.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
I thee wed. I offer you my hand and my heart. And I know they will be safe with you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Chris and Amanda, you have given and pledged your promises to each other and have declared your everlasting love by the exchanging of rings. Your vows may have been spoken in minutes, but your promises to each other will last until your last breath. You pledge your love, you pledge yourself to meet sorrow and happiness as one family before God and before your family and friends. It is with this in mind, and the power vested in me, that I now pronounce you husband and wife. Wish you may kiss your bride.